This looks like a junkyard, but it's a four-frame nuke. This is a medium box right here underneath the tape. And this is a top cover. And it's got an inch and a half of hard insulation underneath it. And this is a deep box with four frames, but medium frames. And on the bottom is some hard insulation again. So it's insulated on the bottom and on the top, and cool on the sides. And it's got a hole right here and a little bit of extra space right here. So that's it. That's the only ventilation that it has. So the cluster is right about here. And most of the heat is going to rise and do its thing. But the heat will escape through this hole, but it has to go up and sort of circulate. And it's also on a tilt, so most of the heat is going to rise to the back of the hive. So it's not like it's just pouring out of that hole. It's just sort of coming out of that hole when it needs to, I guess, along with some excess moisture. I don't even know if they have a queen, to be honest. It's the story behind this is a bit weird. And the last time I checked it, just before the weather got really cold, I couldn't spot the queen, even though it's a mated queen, and a marked queen, I mean. So I don't know what's up with that. I thought about putting these bees in one of these medium boxes and then putting that box over another strong colony that I know produces lots of heat. So this small colony that doesn't produce as much heat will absorb the heat from a good colony. That's what I was gonna do, but I didn't have time, so we'll see what happens. Right now I've got it ratchet strapped down because this top, it sealed perfectly on the other side and everywhere else, but on this side, it just, no matter how much I pushed it down, it just wouldn't seal. So I ratchet strapped it thinking that would do it, but it didn't. So I ended up just putting tape on it. So this is taped down. So the only way for me to see inside is to tear it to pieces and see what's going on. But that's it. I think they're okay though. They have a fairly good chunk of honey in there, and they're clustered, and that's it. I saw a video recently where someone was talking about, or at least referring to, bees clustering in the winter as being under stress, as if clustering was a stressful thing for bees to do. And I'm not sure, I've never heard that before. It's a stressful thing if they're dying and if they don't have enough warmth and food and things like that to stay alive, but it's not really, I don't know if like coloring it as stress is a different way of, I just don't know if that's, I don't know if that might be an exaggeration. I'm not sure about that, but I don't think bees clustering to stay warm as stressed bees. Now these ones might be, because they're not, they probably could use some wrap, and I haven't wrapped them yet, but so far they're fine. They're not dying. I did take a look in them a little while ago, and they're just nice, beautiful, big cluster from like, just a nice big cluster of bees. And they're not doing anything except sitting on their frames, staying warm, not moving. So they look good. But anyway, I don't even know if they have a queen. And so I thought about taking that extra step of putting them on top of another hive to keep them warm, but I don't know if it's worth it, because if they don't have a queen, then they're gonna die anyway. So, but I do have this little thing, and it's basically a thermal imaging camera that I can hook to this phone that I'm talking into right now, and I can see with this thing where the heat is coming from inside the hive. So I'm gonna plug it in and see what happens. Okay, here we go. You can clearly see the heat. So, there it is. Look at that. Talk about heat. So, right down here, that's the bottom of the hive. I'll just put my finger on it, and the heat from my hand should stay on the hive. Right, there it is. So, that's the bottom of the hive. So, you can see the cluster is mostly up top. But, man, oh man, that's a nice hot cluster, eh? Pretty good. Look at that. This thermal imaging camera doesn't really do the best job. because if you look at the ground, which is also freezing, it seems to be giving off heat too. But you can see. Anyway, I was going to say, you can see that right there, that's the hot spot. That's where the cluster is most clustered. So they're doing, you know, they're doing their thing. And if they seem to run out of honey, I'll just drop some fondant on top of the top bars on a warm winter day, and we'll see how they do. But I'm not planning to put a lot of effort into keeping this colony alive, this small colony alive, because I don't know where that queen is. So if they don't have a queen, then I'm not wasting my time and resources on it. But if they do, well then, well, we'll see. That's the report for my little bee yard I've got. I've got this one. I've got another hive right there behind it. I've got another one in front of my house, and I got another one beside my house, and then I have two in another location. So it's a bit of a mishmash of everything this year. And a little bit of everything too. Some hives, again, are wrapped, and some hives aren't, and some hives are in the process of being wrapped. And every one of them is slightly different than the other. I'm constantly experimenting with stuff. But anyway, there you go. So there's heat in there, and they're alive. So good enough for now.